Good morning, everyone. I'm Audrey Gordon, the MLA for Southdale, and I'm glad to see that everyone made it in safely this morning on the drive-in. We are happy to be here today at Klinic Community Health Centre, which provides a multitude of valuable services to the community. I want to thank you all for being here today as we announce a meaningful investment in mental health services. But before we announce that investment, I want to welcome a few special people who have joined us today. So from Klinic Board Chair Natalie Muller, hello, and Nicole Chammartin from Executive Director of Klinic, and also the Board Chair from Klinic, from the Laurel Centre, Nicole Merrick. Hi, Nicole, and the Executive Director Heather Leeman. Good morning, thanks for joining us. So 2 months ago, our party announced a number of health initiatives that a progressive conservative government would implement if we were re-elected. We're thankful that Manitobans did their part in re-electing our government. Now it's our turn to do what our government is known for, and that is keeping our promises. Here to talk more about today's announcement is my friend, Cathy Cox, the minister responsible for the status of women.
Well, thank you, Audrey, and thank you to everybody for being here today. I know the weather just caused a few challenges for all of us in getting here, but we did arrive safely, so that's a great thing. And it really is my pleasure to be here today at Klinic Community Health Centre, and you are such an important organization that provides such important services to our community. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you to you. And thank you as well to Laurel Centre for all that you do for Manitobans. We also know that people who receive the help they need to overcome these traumas are far more likely to lead productive, meaningful lives. And being able to access trauma care and other mental health services on a drop-in basis is essential. And it's a very essential part of the care and the services that we are working towards here in Manitoba. And that is why we are here today. And I am very happy to announce that our government will be investing nearly $2.4 million over the next 3 years to expand walk-in mental health services and specialized trauma counseling. And this money will be invested right here at Klinic and the Laurel Centre. The funding will support the expansion of Klinic's drop-in counseling services by 8 hours per week. And we've had that discussion just a while ago, and it's going to be so important to Klinic and the Laurel Centre, the funds that are going to be provided to expand these important counseling services. And it'll also be used to expand Klinic's longer-term trauma counseling program, as well as to create a centralized trauma intake and a referral service that can be accessed 7 days per week. And finally, our investment will allow the Laurel Centre to increase the number of therapists it has on staff, allowing more women to receive the help they need while significantly reducing waiting lists. This investment reduces barriers to care, shortening wait times, and ensuring quicker access to mental health care. More people will receive the services and help that they need. And it also fulfills the recommendation made in the Virgo report to enhance and accelerate support for people experiencing sexual and other significant trauma. And it upholds, as Audrey said, the commitment we made during our campaign. And these new initiatives follow a number of recent announcements that we've made as part of our continued commitment to improving mental health services and addiction services. And some of the other initiatives that were announced include the expanding the distribution of Thrival kits and increasing support for the Norwest Youth Hub, investing in an expanded Project 11 run by True North, and implementing the Métis Chart pilot program. I promise you there is more good news on the horizon. By the time Christmas rolls around, our government will have announced an additional 12 new initiatives to improve mental health and addictions here in Manitoba. And like the announcement we made today, all will make a significant difference in the lives of Manitobans. Thank you for the opportunity to be here today. I look forward to working with the board chairs of Klinic and the Laurel Centre as we continue to move Manitoba forward with regard to health and addiction services here in Manitoba. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Cathy. Today's announcement would not have happened without the hard work of the people at Klinic and the Laurel Centre. These two organizations work tirelessly to provide services that help Manitobans. Here to talk more about what this new investment means for services here at Klinic is the Executive Director, Nicole Chammartin.
Hi. I want to start with saying I was in Victoria yesterday and today was very shocking. So if it takes me a minute to center myself, I apologize. I'd like to start by recognizing that we and our home here at Klinic is located in the treaties or in the territories of the Cree, Oji-Cree, Dene, Anishinaabe, and Dakota people and the homeland of the Métis Nation. At Klinic, we have tremendous gratitude that we are able to be a part of and in service to our community and continue working together in a good way. I want to thank the Minister for being with us here today, MLA Gordon for being with us here today, and also everyone in the Manitoba government who has supported and worked with us on this pretty significant service expansion. As you've heard today, the Manitoba government is making a new investment in Klinic to support the expansion of counseling services that we provide in Manitoba. This investment will enable Klinic to realize part of our strategic goal of more accessible and responsive care in our communities. At Klinic, our staff work hard every day to cultivate caring and accessible clients and community-centered care. I want to thank the Klinic team who are at heart of this work and our board of directors for their leadership. Meeting the need is not easy to do in a world where the requests for mental health-connected services are increasing every day. It is a challenge that we will need to be met with thoughtful and well-positioned resources that are aimed at providing care and support at many levels. Before I start this analogy, I'm also going to tell you I've spent the last week trying to build a bed that I ordered from a company, I won't name it, and it was very traumatic. Well, not really, but so you might see that in the rest of my discussion, but as they say, if all you have is a hammer, everything starts to look a lot like a nail. I like to think of community healthcare like Klinic as the foundation. So kind of like drywall screws, I think. If you invest in building the foundation strong, you need a lot less nails in the future. We appreciate that the critical importance of community-based care came through loud and clear in the Virgo report on mental health in Manitoba. It also highlighted that we apparently have maybe a few looser screws in our system that need to be tightened. So, this funding will allow us to expand our drop-in counseling program to operate 6 days a week, up to 100 new clients in our counseling program. And by capitalizing on current resources and enhancements to our crisis program and emerging technology, we hope to be able to work with health authorities throughout Manitoba in order to access more counseling services. I think it's important to say that this is the largest single investment in our counseling service in decades, and a direct result of recommendations that we made in response to the Virgo report. It is also the second mental health strategy investment in Klinic this year, starting with the mobile withdrawal management service just a few months ago. We are extremely grateful to have been heard and to be trusted to help address key service gaps in our community. We look forward to continuing to work and collaborate and build a stronger mental health system for Manitobans. Thank you.
Thank you, Nicole. Since 1985, the Laurel Centre has provided services to women struggling to overcome trauma resulting from childhood sexual abuse. It has gained recognition over the years for its unique contribution to women's health. Our government is proud to support the incredible work they do to help women in our province. So here today to talk more about this new investment and how it will help the work done at the Laurel Centre is the Executive Director, Heather Leeman.
Thank you, everyone. The Laurel Centre is a trauma-specific therapy centre that has been providing therapeutic services to female-identifying adults and youth impacted by childhood sexual abuse for over 30 years. For the past 10 years, through the Men's Resource Centre, we have also offered a male childhood sexual abuse program. Childhood sexual abuse continues to be a serious and widespread issue. In North America, 1 in 3 girls and 1 in 6 boys will be sexually abused before the age of 18. It occurs at every socioeconomic level, across ethnic and cultural lines, within all religions, and at all levels of education. The type of trauma that is associated with childhood sexual abuse is developmental, and it often occurs in relationship. It impacts an individual's mental health, their sense of safety, their ability to cope with daily challenges, and their inclination to form and trust healthy relationships. Individuals who have experienced childhood sexual abuse are at greater risk of developing a mental illness and are more likely to use substances as a way of coping. We currently have 240 adult women, 99 adult men, and 22 female-identifying youth on our varying wait lists. If no additional funding was provided, these numbers would translate into the 3-year waiting period for women, over 5 years for men, and 18 months for youth. So this additional funding means that we can hire 3.5 therapists to provide trauma-specific therapy to individuals who are impacted by childhood sexual abuse. It means that for the first time in 10 years, women contacting the Laurel Centre could potentially only have a year waiting period for therapy. It means a significant number of childhood sexual abuse survivors will begin their healing journey. They will realize they're not alone. They will learn healthier ways to cope with their trauma and with their mental health symptoms. They will reduce and end their substance abuse. They will find new ways and new reasons to keep themselves safe. And they will access costly crisis and emergency services less often. Ultimately, this funding means giving more individuals the opportunity to resolve the impacts of trauma so that they can lead satisfying and productive lives. So on behalf of the Board of Directors, staff, and clients of the Laurel Centre, I'd like to thank the Manitoba government for recognizing and investing in this important work that we do. Thank you.
Thank you, Heather, and thank you to everyone who's joined us today. This concludes the formal portion of today's announcement. Cathy, Nicole, and Heather will be available to the media in a few moments after we've had a brief photo op. In the meantime, I do want to say and remind the media and all our guests here today that this is an active clinic, and to please respect the people's privacy both here and outside the facility. So thank you again, and have a safe drive to wherever your day takes you. Thank you. Can I? I'm just gonna sneak a quick